Fela was born Olufela Olusegun Oludotun Ransom Kuti on 15 October 1938 in Abeokuta, Ogun State, Nigeria, into an upper middle class family. His mother, Funmilayo Ransom Kuti, was a feminist activist in the anti-colonial movement in Nigeria. She was the first woman in Nigeria to actually drive a car. His father, Reverend Israel Oludotun Ransom Kuti, a protesting minister and school principal, was the first president of the Nigerian Union of Teachers. Fela was sent to London in 1958 to study medicine. Instead, decided to study music at the Trinity College of Music. While there, he formed the band Kula Lobitos, playing a fusion of jazz and highlife. In 1963, Fela moved back to Nigeria and reformed Kula Lobitos and trained as a radio producer for the Nigerian Broadcasting Corporation. He played with Victor Olaya and his Allstars for some time. In 1967, Fela traveled to Ghana to think up a new musical direction for his life. While there, he had an epiphany, and Afrobeat was born. And in 1969, Fela took the band to the United States, where they spent 10 months in Los Angeles. And while there, Fela discovered the Black Power movement through Sandra Smith, now Sandra Isidore, a partisan of the Black Panther Party. The experience will greatly influence his music and political views. He renamed the band Nigeria 70. Soon after, the Immigration and Naturalization Service was tipped off by a promoter that Fela and his band were in the US without work permits. The band performed a quick recording session in Los Angeles that would later become and be released as the 69 Los Angeles Sessions. After Fela and his band returned to Nigeria, the group was renamed the African 70, as is typical, as his lyrical theme changed from love to social issues. He then formed the Calcutta Republic, a commune, a recording studio, and a home for the many people connected to the band that he later declared independent from the Nigerian state. Fela set up a mighty nightclub in the Empire Hotel, first named Afro Sport, and then the African Shrine, officiating at personalized Yoruba traditional ceremonies in honor of his nation's ancestral roots, and also changed his middle name to Anikolapo Kuti, meaning he who carries death in his pouch, stating that his original middle name, Ransom, was a slave name. At this time, Fela's music had become popular not just in Nigeria alone, but all over Africa. This made him decide to sing in Pidgin English. But despite his popularity among the peoples of Africa, he was very unpopular with the ruling government, and raids on Calcutta Republic were frequent. In 1977, Fela and the African 70 released the album Zombie, a scattering attack of Nigerian soldiers. The song Zombie was a metaphor to describe the methods of the Nigerian military. The album was a smash hit and infuriated the government, setting off a vicious attack on the Calcutta Republic. 1,000 soldiers attacked the commune. Fela's elderly mother was thrown out a window, causing fatal injuries which cost her a dear life. This incident led him to write two songs, Unknown Soldiers and Coffin for Head of State. As he delivered his mother's coffin to Dodon Barracks in Lagos, the residence of General Olusegun Obasanjo. Despite all the setbacks, Fela bounced back. He went on to form his own political party in 1976 called Movement of the People and put himself forward as president, but his candidature was rejected. He went on to create a new band called the Egypt 80, In 1984, Muhammadu Buhari's government jailed him on charges of currency smuggling. After 20 months, General Ibrahim Babangida released him. Fela was a great Nigerian, a great citizen of the world, a star, a prophet of some sort, a multi-talented instrumentalist, a musician, composer, pioneer of the Afrobeat music genre, human rights activist and political maverick, a number one citizen of the world who puts the Nigerian map on the stamp of the world, a father and a brother to Olukoye and Beko, two prominent doctors, Ransom Kuti, first cousin to Nobel laureate Wole Soyinka. On 3rd August 1997, his elder brother, two-time Minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Dr. Olukoye Ransom Kuti, stunned the entire world by announcing that his younger brother's death, Kaposi Sarcoma, was AIDS-related. Yes, AIDS-related. More than a million people attended Fela's funeral. And years later, in 2012, Fela's Life and Times was adapted and showcased on Broadway, a show that went on to win awards.
Ararara!
Long live Fela Anikolapo Kuti. May your spirit live on.
I said, look who Yaradua. Before anything at all, he go to shout.